Well, hi there, Slam is here from the DAB 330 course in QUT. I'm gonna go with you through how to import a screen that you've done on Grasshopper into your Revit model, if you have a Revit model, of course. So right now you can see a screen here which was done by Ivan Magdi in a couple of video series on how to make screens. It's as you can see, it is done on Rhino through the Grasshopper plugin. So we want to take this screen and insert it into our Revit models there. Okay, so this is our Revit model, which would should look similarly to the one in Rhino, and we want to take that there. So first of all, we have to make sure that the screen actually exists in the Rhino viewport, not just a Grasshopper element. So if you go and just hide this, you can find that screen actually does not exist. So we need to make it there. So first things is we're gonna take the last item here, which is our final screen, and right click on it and just press make, which would actually transform this into our Rhino model. So if you hide this now, it finds the screen here on the Rhino model. So we want to take this screen and put it in our Revit model. So we have to export that. So first things is to select our screen and make sure that it's selected up there, and go to File and Export Selected. Okay, we're gonna name it as Tutorial Screen, and make sure that we are selecting the .sat option, which is one of the first options right there. And make sure that you're using the inventor object option in the SAT export options, which is pretty similar to what Revit and how it deals with solid objects from other software. So we have that, and we're gonna press OK. Okay, now we go to Revit, and what we want to do is to import this screen that we've done into our Revit model. So the best option is to use the Masking and Size tab, and we're gonna place our screen here as a mask, where in the future where you can use this mask and just place a wall by face on this mask, so we have a generic wall, Revit generic wall, which Revit just reads well. So we're gonna use in place mask option, and we're gonna name this our screen, our Rhino screen. And we're gonna go to insert and import CAD here, and we're gonna use our tutorial screen. And just make sure that you're selecting the file, the .sat file format, and press open. Okay, now we're having our screen here, and we can finish our mask right now. We don't need anything from that. And there's this warning where it's telling you there's only mesh geometry, so don't worry about that. Actually, we just want to use the face to place like a wall on it, and that's it. So we're gonna go back to our masking inside, and as you can see, this wall is actually it seems transparent or ghosted, and it doesn't have a thickness because this is just like a 2D plane. So we're gonna use the wall by face option that's in masking inside tab, and make sure this is selected. Pick faces, and we're gonna pick this face to put our wall in it. And you can actually change the type of the wall construction before you just place it. Okay, so make sure that you're using one of the basic wool, not a curtain wool or not a stack wool. So we're gonna use a stud timber one, and just pick this face. And as you can see now, we have our a screen with a thickness and materials that we can use in our Revit in our Revit model when we present or visualize a model. So you actually don't need the screen anymore. You can just hide that from here, and you actually can see that in the elevations, or if you take a section, for example, through the mass. So let's say you're having a section here, and you can just take that and see that here. And you can see it's a section right here. So yeah, that's it for how to import a screen from Rhino to Revit. So I hope you all benefit from this, and yeah, good luck in your design projects.